Good morning to our special guest, Dr. Hawkins. Have already welcomed everyone, but on behalf of the family, I would like to welcome and thank each of you for coming. I had took the time to plan this long, I would say, a list of accolades that John had accomplished. Then I said to myself, they know about all of that. I need to tell them some things about John that they might not know. The John Lewis that I knew, the John Lewis that I want you to know about is the John Lewis that would gravitate toward the least of us. Would drop by his four-year-old nephew's birthday party. He would feed the hungry and homeless on Thanksgiving Day. Took the time to go by a young man's house in Troy that had portrayed a young John Lewis in his Black history class, asking his young brothers to be part of his special guest list while receiving the Medal of Freedom from President Barack Obama. Making a surprise visit to his great nephew's fifth grade class at Charles Henderson. Always attending family functions, even if he could only stay for an hour or so because of his busy schedule. He was always concerned about the health and well-being of his family and members of others. To sum up his life of John Lewis, I would say he worked a lifetime to help others and made the world a better place in which to live. And on a personal note, I talked to John on Thursday, the day before he passed, and we would always have these interesting conversations. He would always ask me, how's everybody doing? No matter how bad he felt. So we exchanged the love we had for each other Thursday night. And his last word was, how's the family doing? How's everybody doing? And I said, they're doing fine. He said, well, you make sure to tell them that I asked about him. And on a little bit of a humorous side, when John was first sworn into Congress, I think I got my year right, in 1986, I was there. And during the swearing-in ceremony, right before the swearing-in ceremony, he looked up. He knew where I was sitting. And he looked up and he gave me the thumbs up. And I gave him the thumbs up back. So after the event was over, we was together, and I asked him. I said, John, what were you thinking when you gave me the thumbs up? He said, I was thinking this was a long way from the cotton fields of Alabama. So, and those are the memories that I have with my brother. We would have these late night conversations and early morning conversations where he would call me 11, 12 o'clock at night, and he'll ask me, are you asleep? And I say, no, I'm not asleep, John. But actually, I will sleep. And he'll say, have you heard from Freddie or Bibby lately? I said, yes, talked to him a few days ago. Well, I think I'll call him. I said, don't call him tonight. Call him tomorrow. I said, because it's late. But that's the John Lewis that we grew to love, and our family natural would miss him. But he was at peace. He was at peace, and he was ready to meet the Lord. Thank you. I'm standing right back here.
Good morning, everybody.
Loud.
My name is Jackson Lewis Brewster, and Congressman John Lewis was my uncle and my hero. And it's up to us to keep his legacy alive. Thank you, guys.
Good morning. John Robert Lewis, my big brother, humble man, simple man, and a man of God. He always wanted to improve the lives of others without any concern for himself. His deep faith in God made him extraordinary. He was fearless by trusting in God because he was chosen. He lived with a never-ending desire to help others. He often told us, if you see something wrong, do something. His actions showed us just that. In a time when going to jail was perceived as trouble, he reminded us that it was good trouble, necessary trouble. See something, say something, do something. Thank you.